The American psychologist Erickson said, "We have an innate desire to know others and be known by others. It is through our relationship with others that we develop our sense of identity. This is why when we uproot ourselves and move to another country, it can be challenging, because we leave behind the place, the smells, the sounds, and most importantly, the people who we know and who know us. The group of people I'm studying, they go through this process of being uprooted and rerouted repeatedly while growing up. For example, military kids, children of refugees, children of academics, and other expatriate workers. And the most famous is Barack Obama. Born in the US, he moved to Indonesia at age 6, then back to the US 4 years later. But why does an internationally mobile childhood matter? You see, there are different ways that we can relate to the dominant culture in our society. As a white Australian here, you look like the majority and share their culture. You are like a mirror to those around you. But in Japan, you look different, think differently. You know you're a foreigner, they know you're a foreigner. But if you're Asian, born in Australia, like Kylie Kwong, then you think you know you're a local, but they may think you're a foreigner, as in an adopted country. But in China, they'll think you're a local, but you may not even speak Chinese, like a hidden immigrant. Obama, when he went back to the US at age 10, he had a hard time fitting in. Of course, he had no idea how to throw a football. He walked around saying, "Hey, how come nobody's playing badminton? You know, the national sport of Indonesia." And his classmates, they've known each other since preschool, but he was the new kid on the block. Imagine doing this over and over and over. My research investigates the dynamics at work when we try to connect with others. My findings are crucial for understanding how to manage diversity and multicultural education. I observed students of 60 nationalities at an international school for 1 year. I interviewed over 100 people. Through their lived experiences, I learned that overcoming difference can be simple if we know how. I asked them, "What makes you feel like an insider?" And they said, "When people say hi to me, when people show interest in them, not based on partiality because they come from an advanced country or speak with a cool accent, but when people show interest in them as individuals, then they feel like an insider. Why? Because we have a desire to know others and be known by others." Thank you.
That's fascinating. It's a really important question, and I think that probably half the room at least finds themselves in one or other of these boxes. I wonder if, has your research revealed to some extent that one of these categories is harder than any of the other categories for people? Do you get a sense of what is the most difficult?
Both the adopted and the hidden immigrant are the difficult ones, because with the mirror and the foreigner one, both the people around you and you know where you stand. But it's when you're in the adopted box or the hidden immigrant, then there's a difference in opinion of what you think and what others perceive in you. Yeah.
Okay. Thank you.
Danau, can I ask, with regard to your research, where would you envisage the application being?
The application would be pretty much everywhere, because with globalization becoming more and more important or significant in our lives, there's just a lot more people who are moving around. And even when they do stay in one country, when the society becomes multicultural, you're moving between cultures within that society. You could be going to one culture in the daytime at school and then go home in another culture. So it's very applicable to pretty much everywhere in the world. Yeah.
Thank you.